This presentation should help you to repeat the preparations, but not substitute the review of the original preparations under the microscope before the exam. Two preparations from skin and its appendages unit. Epidermis and dermis of thick skin. Skin of finger, thick skin. Epidermis and dermis. Epidermis is stratified squamous keratinized epithelium. It consists of 5 layers. First basal layer, located at the basal membrane, stratum spinosum. Third, stratum granulosum, contain in cytoplasm small basophilic granules. Stratum lucidum, it's usually bright pink layer, no cells visible. Stratum squamosum consists of many layers of squamous. Dermis consists of papillary layer and reticular layer. Papillary layer is mostly loose fibrous connective tissue, and reticular layer, it's dense irregular connective tissue. Skin with hair, it's thin skin, the very thin epidermis and dermis and hypodermis, adipose tissue or subcutis. Epidermis consists of 4 layers: stratum basalis, spinosum, granulosum, and very thin stratum squamosum. Stratum corneum. No stratum lucidum here. The papillary layer of dermis, reticular layer. The hair root. And bulb, papilla. Erector pili muscle. Sebaceous glands. Sweat glands. Secretory portions. Inner and outer epithelial chairs, connective tissue chairs. three preparations from a respiratory system. Trachea transverse section, three membranes in the wall, inner mucous membrane, fibrocartilage, and outer adventitial membrane. Mucous membrane consists of two layers, surface epithelium. It's simple, pseudostratified, columnar, ciliated epithelium. It consists of basal cells, Campbell cells. Ciliated cells with cilia, which can move. Goblet cells, which produce the droplets of mucous secret. And intermediate cells, supported cells. Under epithelium there is a loose connective tissue of lamina propria. Very thin muscular layer, it almost absent. And in submucosa there are glands, secretory portions of glands. And you can see some ducts. Fibrocartilage layer consists of semirene of hyaline cartilage. At the periphery you can see perichondrium. There's a chondroblasts, stem cells located, zone of young cartilage, zone of mature cartilage with isogenic groups. Tendon tissue, mostly dense connective tissue. Lung. The preparation, you can see bronchi. You should distinguish them to arteries and veins. The plan of structure is similar to trachea. It's also tubular organs. Consists of three membranes, mucous, fibrocartilage, and adventitia. Mucous membrane consists of four layers, surface epithelium, also pseudostratified, columnar ciliated, like in trachea. Thin layer of loose connective tissue, lamina propria, lamina muscularis, good developed, consist of smooth muscle cells, and in submucosa there are numerous mixed glands. Fibrocartilage membrane consists of a large islands, islets of hyaline cartilage. So we can suggest that this is the middle bronchus. This is a small bronchus, no cartilage, no glands. And this is terminal bronchioles. And then the respiratory division starts, which consists of respiratory bronchioles, respiratory or alveolar ducts and sacs, and everywhere you can see alveoles, semi-sacs. Only here the gas exchange between air, inspire air, and blood. In blood capillaries surrounding alveoles take place. So bronchi and terminal bronchioles belong to the airways, and others, including alveoles, belong to the respiratory portion of lung and respiratory system. Urinary system. Kidney. It's parenchymal organ covered by capsule and tiny connective tissue layers. There are cortex at the periphery and medulla in the center. The cortex composed of renal bodies, consist of capillary glomerulus in the center and capsule of nephron, and between the external and internal inner layer of capsule there is a cleft like a urinary space, and around glomeruli there are convoluted tubules. Most of them belong to proximal part, no lumen visible in them because it filled by microvilli of the brush border, and few distal convoluted tubules, no microvilli, so the lumen looks empty. Straight ducts as well as a collecting tubules compose the medulla of kidney. The borderline between cortex and medulla waving. It's because the renal bodies of different nephrons located at different levels as to capsule. So straight tubules compose loops of Gönle. It may be thin and thick. And this is apex of pyramids, the lobules of kidney. Here in the apex, or renal papilla, collect in tubes, fuse and compose papillary ducts, which release the final urine into the small collicle. The small collicles, like other urinary passing organs, linen by stratified transitional epithelium. And here, under epithelium, located blood vessels and adipose tissue, in addition to connective tissue. Ureter. It's typical tubular lining organs, consist of three membranes: inner mucous membrane, middle muscle, and outer adventitia. Mucous membrane consists of two layers: surface epithelium, stratified transitional, then lamina propria consists of loose connective tissue, muscle membrane consists of two layers of smooth muscle cells, inner longitudinal and outer circular layer, and around adventitia, dense connective tissue. Urinary bladder has the same plan of structure as ureter, but here only piece of its wall represented. All the three membranes, inner mucous membrane, linen by stratified transitional epithelium, you see basal cells, intermediate and surface cells. In this case, they are round. You can suggest that there was empty urinary bladder just before sampling. Loose connective tissue, lamina propria, and through layer of smooth muscle cells in the lamina muscularis. Male reproductive system. Testis, parenchymal organ. Stroma represented by connective tissue capsule and connective tissue layer. There are many sections of convoluted seminiferous tubules. It consists of epithelium spermatogenic cells lying on the basal membrane. epithelial cells are supporting Sertoli cells, Varolach cells is white bases located at basal membrane, is Varolach nucleus. It's really not visible, the preparation, and this microphotogram. It's visible on the preparation. This large pale triangle or oval nuclei. And by the apical portion, they reach the lumen of the seminiferous convoluted tubule. And spermatogenic epithelial, every layer of cells correspond to the stage of spermatogenesis. First stage, proliferation. It uses the numerous spermatogonia near the basal membrane. They have small dark nuclei. Second line belong to primarily spermatocytes with large pale nuclei with tetraploid set of chromosomes. Then secondary spermatocytes and then spermatids. No spermatozoa visible in this particular section. Between seminiferous tubules, there are interstitial tissue with endocrine Leydig cells, which produced male sex hormone testosterone. You can find also here numerous blood vessels. Epididymis, it's parenchymal organ covered by capsule and a lot of adipose tissue around. Consists of head and body, this tail, and under higher magnification of microscope you can see the differences between tubules. The head composed by efferent ducts. They contain a simple epithelium which consists of two types of cells, cuboidal secretory cells and columna ciliated cells. Inside you can find the spermatozoa. And other sections of the body and tail belong to the duct of epididymis. It's larger and its wall consists of pseudostratified or sometimes stratified two layers of epithelial cells. Their apical portions sometimes contain sterile cilia. They cannot move actively. And inside, visible spermatozoa. This is prostate of child. This ureter In the center, the lumen, leaning by stratified transitional epithelium, and around a lot of connective tissue, stroma, containing a lot of smooth muscle cells, which will contract and help to release the secret. But here the glands, non-developed and not secreted, it's not active. They start to actively secreted and growing after sexual maturation in adult. Here you see the capsule and active secreting prostatic glands. The secretory portions are leaning by simple columnar epithelium. Female reproductive system, ovary, sporangymal organ covered by capsule, tunica albuginea. At the periphery cortex, containing follicles and the derivatives. The medulla in the center consists of blood vessels, loose connective tissue. There are several types of follicles. The smallest, like small vesicles, the most numerous, located under the capsule. Primary follicles, much larger, contain one, two layers of follicular cells, and primary oocyte in the center. Secondary follicles contain the primary oocyte, surrounded by zona pellucida and numerous follicular cells. They produce the follicular fluid containing estrogens. Epithelium line the basal membrane and around theca. And this is atretic follicle. This folded zona pellucida of dyed oocyte, and around the remnants of the follicular cells and thecocytes. Corpus albicans, dense connective tissue, irregular dense connective tissue on the place of corpus luteum, which died by apoptosis. Tertial follicle, cumulus aphoricus with oocyte, granulose layer around, cavity filled in by follicular fluid with estrogens, basal membrane, theca, inner and outer layers. corpus luteum, its temporal endocrine gland. This is corpus luteum of pregnancy. Very large gland inside the ovary. Capsule around a loose connective tissue septa. It's typical parenchymal organ. Lutein cells which produce progesterone and a lot of blood capillary around. Oviduct, tubular organ, consists of three membranes. Mucous membrane, which make numerous folds, branching folds, make labyrinth. Lamina muscularis consists of two layers of smooth muscle cells and outer adventitial layer and sometimes serose. Epithelium is simple columna, consists of two types of cells, secretory and ciliated cells. Uterus is cleft like lumen. Its tubular line organ consists of three membranes, inner mucous membrane and endometrium, middle muscle muscular membrane, myometrium, and outer serose membrane, perimetrium. Muscle membrane consists of three layers. Inner submucous, middle vascular, because contain numerous large vessels, blood vessels, and outer serose membrane governed by mesothelium. This is just mucous membrane high magnification. It's endometrium, not thick, it contains very small developing uterine glands. It's postmenstrual phase, phase of proliferation. Compare this secretory premenstrual phase, when the endometrium increased in several times. Surface epithelium also became much thicker, and numerous very large uterine glands actively functioning, secreting. Mammary gland, its parenchymal organ, consists of capsule and loose connective tissue septa, dividing organ for lobules. The secretory portions, alveoles lining by simple columna epithelium. Intra lobular and interlobular ducts lining by pseudostratified or stratified epithelium. Lacteriferous ducts inside the milk. Blood vessel. For preparations from embryology. Human sperms in this manner of ejaculate sperma. This is spermatozoa. Their heads and tails. Oocyte in an ovary. This is a secondary follicle. Oocyte, its nucleus, your conclusions in cytoplasm, zona pellucida, follicular cells around, its future corona radiata, primitive streak, embryo, ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm. Primitive streak and groove. And this is the embryo, 3 gem layers. Ectoderm, endoderm, and mesoderm. Nerve tubed, tube derived from neuroectoderm. Horda. Mesoderm differentiated into 3 parts, summits, nephrogonotomes, and splanchnotomes, visceral and parietal layers. This secondary cavity of the embryo, coelom. And these are the precursor of the heart, developing heart. Placenta, fetal part, distinguished by amnion connecting this chronic plate and amniotic epithelium, simple columnar epithelium. Large villi, these large blood vessels, small villi, these small blood vessels and blood capillaries inside, and around maternal blood. And placenta, maternal part, consists of decidua basalis, with numerous decidual cells, and these are villi of Huron. These small blood vessels, blood capillaries inside, and around the maternal blood. Some villi covered by fibrinoid. You can find here the symplasta, trophoblast, and cytotrophoblast, and connective tissue of the villi.